Baha'is believe that all religions come from the same source, and that the purpose of all of these religions is to unite people and to teach us about love and teach us how to become more peaceful and harmonious. So this interfaith harmony is so critical.
The Edmonton Interfaith Centre for Education and Action is the first of its kind in Canada. It is a coalition, a community of 13 or more faith traditions, which are many of our first dialogues, were just among the Abrahamic faiths, Jewish, Christian, Muslim. But we're in a city populated by Jains and Zoroastrians and Sikhs and Buddhists and Hindus and indigenous people. People who profess to be atheists have a place at the table as well.
When I discovered the Interfaith Centre in the late 1990s, I joined immediately and became involved because it's so important. The more we know about each other, the better we get along, and the fewer misunderstandings we'll have.
We all have to learn how to cooperate and figure out how to get along, otherwise you do end up with wars. And so the only way you work with that is trying to understand each other a little bit better and finding your common ground. What things do you all believe in? What things do you all hold important?
The important thing is the ethics. How you treat other people and how you see other people. That's the important thing. That's part of that commonality.
My name is John Dowds, and my position in the city is I'm the lead chaplain and the senior mental health consultant for the City of Edmonton employees and their families. So this is the Celebrating Our Faiths cabinet, and the purpose of the cabinet is to give the faith communities that are a part of the Interfaith Centre an opportunity to tell their story. I think we have a great lack of understanding of other faith traditions, and lack of understanding sometimes either breeds contempt sometimes or fear. I think the more we understand and the more we talk, then there's a greater sense, there's a greater opportunity to break down some of the walls of fear. We can't do that if we keep talking about us and them.
Today's global fight is not between peoples, communities, or religions. It is between all moderates of all faiths against all extremists in all religions.
A lot of the times religion has been corrupted by people who have selfish desires or want power or money or want to use religion as a means to control.
It's not about religion, it's about power, and it's about politics like everything else. It's about the exploiting the flaws in human nature, how easy it is to turn one group of people against another on a religious basis or an ethnicity basis, Hutus and Tutsis, Germans and Jews. It's not about religion, and if we had more religious literacy, people would know that. But
if you look deep enough into each religious group, you've got good and bad people in there. So to me, it has nothing to do with the faith or the lack of faith. It has to do with the person and what values they hold and how they were raised and things like that. So faith is a vehicle for it, but not the necessary vehicle for it.
I think what unifies is our common commitment to peace and justice and compassion, and to be this voice for the offended, victimized, and oppressed. We're still coming to terms with truth and reconciliation with Indigenous people, and Indigenous people have been part of the Edmonton Interfaith Centre almost from its beginnings.
Indigenous spirituality was rejected by the church itself many years back. Their spirituality is deeply rooted into Mother Earth, into the land, into the relationship with the people. So how they practiced in their own way has to be brought back.
Father talked about the importance of healing together as all nations. And we come together here, that's why I'm here, because I separated from the church when I was a young boy, and through my own personal healing came back.
It's so important to understand our own values, our own traditions, and to share them openly and honestly. When we don't share who we are as individuals, you know, like the different cultures, it creates fears. You know, you're standoffish against those people. So you don't want to deal with them, you're afraid to ask them anything. So that creates a like a blockage, you know, and it creates a hatred.
I think education is a key. Very often, a lot of hatred is based on misunderstanding, on stereotypes, and you need to break those barriers down. The only way you do it is through dialogue.
Leaders of every country, every belief, every neighborhood need to take a clear and public stand against intolerance of any kind.
The tendency often is something good happens and we sort of think, oh, well, good, our work is done, things are looking up, and then there'll be some ghastly incident somewhere in the world and we realize that it's only a facade, and it doesn't take much to break through that and see that there is still so much misunderstanding and hatred, true hatred.
Well, take a look at this note right here, left on the doorstep of this Edmonton mosque behind me earlier this week. Its content enough for Edmonton police to submit this for an investigation to its hate crimes unit, with local Muslim officials telling us it's just part of a larger, disturbing trend.
A lot of people act the way that they act because of their ignorance to the reality of other religions. They do not have the awareness or the education that they need to understand and respect each other's point of view. I think once we start respecting and understanding that each person has the right to their own faith within their family, within their community, we can just live better together.
Too often at the extremes are radical elements that aren't at all reflecting the essence of the values of their respective faith traditions. When they've been targeted, there's been this great uprising of people from a whole variety of faith traditions to say, this was not right, how are you? Are you okay? And what can we do to help you?
We had a couple of just fellow citizens that came by and with flowers and said, we're here with you, we support you, we love you. So it's been really sweet. It's showed the true colors of all Albertans.
My name's Carl Fakely, and I teach religious studies, which includes world religions. What I'm hoping that my students get from this is the opportunity to experience these various places of worship and to learn from people who are leaders in these communities and experience them in a way that would be far more in-depth than just simply reading about it in a textbook, and to learn about it in a very real way, to see how the people in these communities are helping within their communities, being there to support one another.
What we are here right now, we're actually in the Langar Hall. Basically, a Langar Hall is a community kitchen. It's probably around 18, 19 hours a day that we serve food to every single person that comes through that door. Doesn't matter of their religion, doesn't matter of their sexual orientation, nothing like that. So if you guys want to just line up, grab a plate and head to the front there, and they'll serve you there. Grab whatever you like, and if you guys want samosas, they're going to be on that table as well. And the thing with a langar hall is that everyone sits on the floor and eats, right? Doesn't matter if it's a king, a queen, and that represents equality, and humankind is all one. The Sikh belief is that we are all part of one God, right? It's just the way we worship God is different, right? It is only one creator in the world.
Like, no matter your religion, no matter your sexual orientation, race, everyone's welcome here. There's respect everywhere, and it's quite nice to see, actually.
People come who are addicted, people who have no homes, people who are really marginalized. Like last night, I had three men asking for shoes and socks, and I gave them whatever we had. So these are daily needs. These are the people directly, they need our help. They know that we go to Sacred Heart, there is something is available.
We do the food bank. We go and volunteer there. We also have a stretch of highway that we clean up. And just regularly there'll be events every now and again where we'll decide to go and volunteer and do things. We've actually got one of our members that's a regular of Catholic Social Services, and she volunteers.
In Judaism, we have the concept of tikkun olam, to repair the world. If you're going to talk the talk, you have to walk the walk. And you have to follow up whatever you say with actual positive actions to change those things that are wrong.
A mosque in North Edmonton is opening its doors as we speak to anyone who doesn't have a warm place to sleep tonight.
Within moments of them putting out a request for help, there was an outpouring of support from volunteers, not just people from this community, people of all religions and cultures.
I think we had about 70 people throughout the whole week that came in and out. And again, that is just our duty as citizens. It really has nothing to do with what religion you practice.
What Baha'is are doing with their friends and their neighbors all across the world. They get together once a weekend and they think about what they can do to help grow their own spiritual qualities like love and patience and compassion, and how they can use these qualities to be of service to their neighbors. And then they do some service projects for their communities.
Loving kindness, compassion, these are all things that all faith traditions teach. So if we can really bring those qualities into our life and try to build on them more and more, regardless of which faith tradition or lack of faith tradition we belong to, if we can concentrate on those guidelines, those principles, we can develop all in the same direction. It doesn't matter what faith tradition we belong to.
Now look at my veins, they're blue. All of us have blue veins. So that tells me we're all royalty, that we're all equal. None of us are superior to the others. Yeah. We're all human, all created by the same divine being.
4 years ago, we helped create the UN's Global Interfaith Harmony Week, an event to focus all people, especially young people, on the essentials of tolerance and coexistence.
The World Interfaith Harmony Week was a United Nations response to a growing awareness and appreciation of interfaith work around the world.
My name is Len Girock, and I have the pleasure of hosting tonight's event as part of World Interfaith Harmony Week 2019.
We are all one people, and this is one of the tenets of the Unitarian Church of Edmonton and of the Edmonton Interfaith Centre. So this concert is put on every year to emphasize that unity.
Dr. King had a great quote about why segregation didn't work. He said, people fear because they don't know. He said, they don't know because they don't communicate, and they don't communicate because they separated. So let's tear that curtain down.
In my mind, the patron saint of the Edmonton Interfaith Center is the late Mary Hall. And it's this little quote here that I find quite attractive and I think is a wonderful quote for any kind of interfaith work. It is in the shelter of each other that people live.